As soon as you join, we will start the class. Now it is already 9:26. We'll go for the homework correction or revision. Like, I will explain the problems which are given on the homework on Tuesday. These are the problems, children. Now we will go for the first problem. Are you able to see the screen? No, not yet.
No, sir.
Present screen option, I did not give you. Okay, sorry. Present screen. Share. Now we will have the present screen option here. Yeah. Now its screen will be presented to you. Now the screen is visible now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, the first problem here, two equations are given. For each equation, we'll find the solutions. Equation 1 is 2x plus y equal to 5. For this, we have to find the solutions. At least two solutions we have to find. Solutions of to the equation 1, first one, let x be equal to 0. In that case, we will have 2 into 0 plus y equal to 5. Then, y equal to 5, 0, 5 is one of the solutions here. 0, 5 is one of the solutions here. Then, let y equal to be 0 now. When y equal to 0, 2x plus 0 equal to 5, then 2x equal to 5 or x equal to 5 by 2, 2.5. This is 2.5 comma 0 is another point. One of you note down these points. When I ask you, tell me the points or take the screenshots immediately. So we'll go for next one. This is equation 1. Solutions are 0, 5 and 2.5, 0. 0, 5, comma, and 2.5, comma, 0. These are the solutions for equation 1. And what is equation 2? Equation 2 is 3x plus 2y equal to 8. For this, the solution, let x be equal to 0. Then 3 into 0 plus 2y equal to 8. 2y equal to 8, so y equal to 4. So, what is the solution here? Solution here is 0, 4. 0, 4 is one of the solutions for equation 2. Now, let us try for another equation. If we let y equal to 0, suppose y equal to 0, then what will happen? This is 0, 3x equal to 8 or x equal to 8 by 3, which cannot be represented easily on the graph sheet. So we will not take this value. Instead, we let x equal to 1 this time. Then what will happen? 3 into 1 plus 2y equal to 8. And then 3 plus 2y equal to 8 or 2y equal to 8 minus 3 equal to 5. So 2y equal to 5, so y equal to 5 by 2, 2.5. So 1, 2.5 is another solution to be plotted on the graph. Now, let us plot all these 4 points on the graph and find the graph of these equations. Now, I am going to take the graph sheet. Graph sheet I am taking. Have you seen the graph sheet, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right, that's right.
Yes, sir.
That's right. Now, I am going to plot the points one by one here. Now, what are the points? First point A, 0, 5 I have to plot. I am plotting that point, 0, 5. Second point, can anybody tell me what is the second point?
2.5, 0, sir.
2.5, 0, it will come here on the x-axis between 2 and 3. Between 2 and 3. Now, what is the next step? You have to draw a line joining these two points, A and B. I am joining them with a green colored pencil. So what happened? A, one line we obtained for the first equation. And let us mark the equation also near the line, 2x plus y equal to 5. So for 2x plus y equal to 5, we have drawn a line on the graph sheet. Now we will take up the points or the solutions of the second equation, that is 0, 4. Is it? Is it 0, 4? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Right. Next point is 1, 2. So 1, 2 also I'll mark like this. And then what to do next? We have to draw a line joining points C and D. I joined like this. Now the lines are very close and finding the point of intersection. You see, you have to find the point of intersection now of these two lines. The point, the both the lines, the red line and the green line, of course we will mark what is the red line. Equation of the red line is 3x plus 2y equal to 8. The two lines for these two equations are drawn on the sheet of paper, a graph sheet here, and the point of intersection is 2 and 1.
2, 1.
Point of intersection is E. The coordinates of E are 2 and 1. Therefore, the solution of these pair of equations is x equal to 1 and y x equal to 2 and y equal to 1. What is the solution for this equation, for the set of equations here? X equal to 2, y equal to 1. So we have solved the first problem. What did we do? We took values, two values for each, two solutions for each of these equations, and plotted them on the graph sheet. Remember children, whatever work I am doing like this, you have to do on the normal homework sheet and this on the graph sheet in general. So this graph sheet can be pasted very close to that particular problem and this problem is completed.
Sir, I have doubt, sir.
Yeah? Doubt. Tell me.
Sir, I wrote for second equation y equal to 0, sir, I taken.
Y equal to...
It gave approximately 2.6, sir.
Y equal to 0, na? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Y equal to 0 for the second equation will give you 8 by 3. 8 by 3 approximately?
2.6, sir.
Approximately, no? Then 2.6 approximately. But
it gives same answer, sir.
You will get, of course, but it is very difficult to mark 2.6 on the graph sheet. Therefore, as far as possible, try to get the integral values. Integral values means integers as values, integers as solutions. Okay? This is the simplest way. Doesn't matter. Your answer is right. I don't say it is wrong. But you would have faced a little tough time to mark that particular point. Anyway, this is the way you have to do you have to solve the problem, first one. Now, let us go for the second question. Question number 2, let us see what are the solutions of question number 2. This is question number 2, equation 1 is x minus 3y minus 7 equal to 0. So we again let x equal to 0, then 3y equal to 7, y equal to minus 7 by 3. Here also getting into integral value, it is very difficult to mark that point. Y minus 7 by 3 for y on the graph sheet. So we will go for another value here. Let x equal to be 1, then 1 minus 3y equal to 7. In that case, minus 3y equal to 7 minus 1, that is 6, or y equal to 6 by minus 3, and the value is minus 2. So what is the point here? What is the solution of this equation? First solution for this equation is 1 minus 2. 1 and minus 2. Then let us take another solution. Let y equal to be 0, then it is very easy. 3y will become 0 in the equation. Therefore, x minus 0 is 7, or x equal to 7. So then 7, 0 is another solution for this particular equation. Now let us see the second equation, equation 2, in the second problem. Again, 3x minus 3y minus 15 equal to 0. Here we can let x equal to 0, then minus 3y equal to 15, or minus 3y equal to 15 will give you y equal to 15 by minus 3 or minus 5. Therefore, the point is 0 minus 5 is the first point to be plotted, or the first solution of this particular equation. Now, for the second solution of this equation, we let y equal to 0, then in that case 3x minus 0 equal to 15, or 3x equal to 15, x equal to 15 by 3, 5. Now those who have already completed this can check their answers, others can note down immediately. So what are the equations here, the points also you remember children? First, the points for the first equation, second equation, when I ask you, you tell me 50, okay. Then the first equation you can see once, first equation 1 minus 2 is one solution, another solution is 70. So now these points will plot on the graph sheet, shall we? Okay, we'll go for the graph sheet now again. This is not the one to be. I'm opening it. Please hold on. Now the graph sheet I am opening to plot these points. First equation, the solutions are 1 minus 2 and 70. Second equation, the solutions are 0 minus 5 and 50. These solutions we plot on the graph sheet here. Now you can see a graph sheet, right? Graph sheet,
yes,
is marked.
Yes, sir.
Graph sheet is marked.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, let us give the equations again here. Now graph sheet is still extended, and then now the first point A 1 minus 2 is plotted here. See, 1 minus 2, A 1 minus 2, and the second point, that is B 70, is on the x-axis. And what to do next? We have to draw a line joining these two points. I'm joining them like this. A and B are joined, and we got a pink line, and we also name the line with the equation, that is x minus 3y minus 7 equal to 0 is represented by this line. Okay, it is a line passing through 1 minus 2, 7 comma 0. Then for the second line, for representing the second equation, first solution is 0 minus 5, that I will plot here. 0 minus 5 will be on the negative side of the y-axis here. Then next point is 50, that is on the x-axis exactly. Next we have to mark, or we have to join these two points by drawing a line. I do a blue line joining the solutions 0 minus 5, 5 comma 0. Then I will name this line as 3x minus 3y minus 15 equal to 0, that is the equation of the line. Now for both the equations, given equations, we have drawn the lines on the graph sheet. Now next, what to do? We have to find the solution. Solution of these two lines is nothing but the point of intersection here, that is 4 comma minus 1. Let us mark the point of intersection and then mark its values also. Those are 4 minus 1. Now question is not left here. Little extension also I have given you, that to share the triangle and determine the coordinates of the triangle formed by the x-axis and the lines. These two are lines, you can understand. This is the x-axis. So triangle DGB is the required triangle. Triangle DGB is the required triangle. Therefore, we have to coordinates you have to give as D 50, G 4 minus 1 and B 7 comma 0. So these are the coordinates, and that is the triangle shaded now. And we are giving solution is x equal to 4, y equal to minus 1, and the coordinates of the triangle formed by these lines and the x-axis are coordinates of the vertices, of course, coordinates of the vertices of the triangle. It should be coordinates of the vertices of the triangle. Coordinates of the vertices of the triangle formed by these lines and the x-axis are like this. I'll put it here somewhere so that you can all see that. Alright. So this is how you have to solve the problem. Any doubt in this solving the problem?
No, sir.
Because the triangle is looking very small, you have to be careful. Okay, sometimes the question may be asked in the other way round. Mark the triangle or shade the triangle formed by the lines and the y-axis. Then in that case, I will just mark and show you what is the triangle. Point, I'll have to go for a point here. Point on the object or point of intersection I'll take. The line here, x-axis, and this line. And this is H. And now the triangle formed by the y-axis and the lines is, I'll show you that triangle now. C, G, and H. And of course, I can do in a different color here. See the triangle. Brown colored triangle is triangle formed by the lines and the y-axis. Blue colored triangle is the triangle formed by the lines and the x-axis. So you have to be very careful and understand the difference between these two. Is it clear to you all children? Any doubt?
Yes, sir. What?
No doubt.
Okay.
Yes, sir means you have doubt.
No, sir.
All right. Let me go back to the normal class for some time. Let us discuss some more things in this. Let us stop the share. Now, I am appearing in front of you now. Board is there, right? So these two problems I am going to send in today's activity, classwork activity. I share it in the Google class. All of you can write down if you want in your homework book. Already those who have written can check, and then today you send that homework to me. Today all of you post homework to me in the Google class. Now coming to one more important thing here about lines, a pair of linear equations in two variables. Without even drawing the graph and solving them, we can find out whether that equation is solvable or not. Whether we will be able to solve the equation or not can be easily understood. And let us, for that we will study certain things here and quickly come to certain conclusions here. So for that again, I will open the screen share and give you the inferences from the presentation there. Let me present the screen again. Now, are you able to see the desktop? Now the presentation is starting.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, presentation is starting now. Now, here we go. These are all the equations here. Equation 1, equation 2. This is what I showed you on the first day. Once again, we'll discuss this. See here, I am going to adjust the lines again and we get a solution here. These are intersecting lines. The lines, blue line and the pink line, they are intersecting at a particular point A. minus 4 and 1.5. So that means they have a solution here, they are intersecting, right? And the first one, this one you see, the lines are not intersecting, they are parallel. When the lines when the lines do not have any common point, then we say the equations have no solution. Sometimes the lines may fall one over the other, one over the other, like this. See, now the second line is coming and merging with the first line. Are you able to see this demonstration now?
Yes, sir.
The blue line is merging. That means the lines, there are three possibilities when you draw, when you represent the graph of a pair of linear equations in two variables. One, the lines may be intersecting, or two, the lines may be parallel to each other. Three, the lines may coincide with each other, coincident lines. So what are the three possibilities? One, intersecting lines. Two, coincident lines. Three, parallel lines. Okay, intersecting, coincident and parallel lines. When these three lines are like this, what is happening to the coefficients of x and y here in the equations? Let us observe. Now let us take the case of solvable equations. Now 0.5, we will take these lines here. Here we will take like this. Now here you observe the ratio of coefficients of x, that is 2 by 1, a1 by a2 is equal to 2 by 1. What is b1 by b2? 4 by 1. 2 by 1 means it is, the value is 2. 4 by 1 means it is 4. Is 2 equal to 4? No. That means a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2 here. That means the ratios of coefficients of x are not equal to the ratio of coefficients of x is not equal to the ratio of coefficients of y. a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. In that case, the graph of the equations is represented as intersecting lines. And also we say the equations are consistent, the pair of equations is consistent, and we can have a solution for this, and that too one and only one solution, that is unique solution. We call it unique solution. So when the line, when the ratio a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, we say we have these conclusions. One, the graph of these lines is intersecting lines, and we say the system of equations or the pair of equations is consistent, and also the pair will have only one solution, unique solution. These three conclusions can be given. Now also we can say, now we will see whether this also I will make 2. Now you check the solutions, 2 by 1 I will give. Now the lines are falling one over the other, or the lines are coincident lines, meaning both the lines are becoming one and only one line. Now in that case, what is happening to this ratios? You see, now a1 by a2 equal to 2 by 1, b1 by b2 is also 2 by 1, means it is again 4 by 2 means 2 by 1 is also 2 by 1. So the ratios are equal, all the three ratios are equal. In that case the lines are coincident. So without drawing the graph of the pair of linear equations, we can conclude these things just by checking the ratios of x coefficients, y coefficients and constant terms. X coefficients and y coefficients, ratios of x coefficients and y coefficients, if the two ratios are equal, we'll find further whether it is equal to the ratio of constants or not. C1 by C2 are also, is also, I, for, to C1 by C2 also. If all the three ratios are equal, we say the lines are coincident. And can anybody tell me what is the solution for this one? Can you find the solution for this graph, for this pair of linear equations?
Infinite solution, sir.
Very good. Who is telling that?
Kiran, sir.
Kiran, good. Infinite number of solutions. Now, here both the lines have become only one line. A linear equation, two variables, only one equation is given. Therefore, infinitely many solutions will be there for this particular set of equations. And suppose the A1 by A2, that means in this case also we say the system is consistent, the pair of equations is consistent, and the graph is coincident lines, and solutions, plenty of solutions are infinitely many solutions for this particular system. Suppose the line, the ratios, first two ratios are equal. A1 by A2 equal to B1 B2.
Inga ave unnai inga appa daggara unnai avu kada.
Now that is not, who is that? Somebody's mic is on, please mute it. Please mute the mic. All right. Now if the first two ratios are equal, but the third ratio is not equal to them, in that case the lines are parallel like this. You can see the parallel lines here. So in any case the first two ratios are equal, but the third ratio is not equal to them. Therefore the lines are parallel. If the lines are parallel, we cannot have a common solution for these two. That means we can say if A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 but not equal to C1 by C2, then the pair of linear equations given is inconsistent, means we cannot solve it. And the graph is parallel lines, and we cannot have any solution for this one. Now, children, it is 9:53. I will stop sharing for a while. We'll go for another screen share of conclusions of all these ones quickly. And tomorrow we can see more examples on this. I stopped the screen share, I think. I'll present again. All right, where did I keep that? Actually, I thought it can be done only tomorrow, but it is happening today. Parallel lines, okay, it is not that, sorry. Not this. Just a moment, please. I mean, this one.